ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் எல்லாருக்கும் நமஸ்காரம். என் பேர் நேஹா சக்சேனா. வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு முந்திரிவல்லிகள் அகேன், திஸ் மூவி இஸ் வெரி க்ளோஸ் டு மை ஹார்ட். திஸ் ரோல் கேம் டு மீ த்ரூ சோஃபியா பால் மேம். ஐ திங்க் யூ கேன் சே ஷீ பிகேம் லைக் அ காட் மதர் டு மீ. ஐ வாஸ் ஷூட்டிங் இன் மும்பை ஃபார் ஒன் ஆஃப் மை கன்னடா ப்ராஜெக்ட், அண்ட் தென் ஐ ஜஸ்ட் காட் அ கால் அரவுண்ட் 10:30 அண்ட் ஷீ ஸ்போக் டு மீ அண்ட் ஐ வாஸ் லைக், மேம் ஹோப் யூ ஆர் நாட் கிடிங் வித் மீ, ஹோப் யூ ஆர் நாட் ஜோக்கிங் வித் மீ. த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மூவி ஆஃப் மம்முக்கு ஆல்சோ ஹேப்பன் த சேம் வே, and we would like to cast you for our film Munthirivallikal, and it is opposite Mohanlal sir. I'm like, oh, what, really? You know, my reaction was like that, pretty excited. I don't know how to, you know, tell you how happy I was, and I'm still happy. So I said, ma'am, when is it starting? She said, you have to be on the sets within 2 days, so please let us know if we can get your dates and all. I'm like, ma'am, even if I don't have dates, I'll make sure I'm there. She's like, oh, that's really very good thing, because it's an opportunity, it's a blessing, you know. I'm still coming up in my life, still coming up in the industry as an artist. And the first break and the second break, when you get to act with two legendary actors, and that too, you can say two main pillars of Mollywood industry, it's a sheer blessing, you know. Or to say, the nan bhagyam. As you say, as you just asked me, that everybody calls him Lalated. You know, his name is Mohanlal, but people call him Lalated. That respect what you give to the people whom you love is very beautiful. Like in Punjab, we say Hanji, Hanji Boliye, Neha Ji, like that. You know, we give that respect. The same thing over here, the minute I in fact ask people, why do you call Lalaten and why it is not Mamu? You know, for Mamuka, it is like Mamuka. It is for Mammootty sir. So they explain me the difference, that what is the difference between Mamuka and Lalaten, why we give that Cheta, Chechi, what are the meanings? Because I don't know the language, I was learning. So acting with Lalaten, it was very, very cool, calm, you know, being a fresher in Malayalam industry, though I have done films in Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, but in Malayalam, I was very, very new. I was rehearsing my dialogues. You won't believe, I was very scared, very, very, very nervous. I'm like, so 1 minute, sir. He's like, Korpela, Korpela, take your time. I'm like, means he was giving me that time. He was helping me in pronouncing, how to pronounce my dialogues, those particular one words, you know, how to pronounce it. When we were shooting in Calicut, Kori Kori, I don't know how to pronounce it. So we were shooting in Panchayat office. And like, as I told, there was a dialogue thing was going on. And then he said, no problem, you take your time. You want me to help you? He was also telling me whether to frown or not to frown. How should be my face expressions? That's where I understood, you know, even the tip of his finger acts actually. Because he was noticing each and every part of my face, how I was acting. And he was also helping me to improvise. Because I don't know the language. So he said, don't concentrate only on the dialogues, concentrate on the expressions also. I was like, wow. So it is like, I became a student of Lalaten. Yes, I've been doing modeling and modeling in Kerala, like shows and print ads and a lot of other TVCs and all that. One of the ad, I did it, Mammooka with 20 beauties. And that's how I met Mammooka and the entire team. So that's how I got to know Mammooka in person. Whenever I used to land at Kochi airport, and I used to see big, big hoardings of Mammooka, and I used to say, wow, he is so handsome. And I really want to work with him. And I think it's like a dream come true when they called me up after 3 months of that magazine shoot, that Neha, we would like to cast you for Mammooka's film Kasaba, and we are shooting in Kolar. We are in Karnataka only. If you are available, please let us know. I was like, hope somebody's playing a, you know, somebody's not playing a prank with me. I was a bit confused that Mammooka, big actor, I'm not a Malayali, I don't know the language. How come I got this offer? I was thinking somebody's playing a prank. But yes, it was the truth. I went to the location, I met everybody. When I met Mammooka for the first time, very stylish, very good looking and all that. But yes, when I met him on the set, of Kasaba first time when there was a discussion about my character. He was very, very humble, very genuine. He asked me, what is your experience and all that. I told him, he said, will you be able to manage the language? I said, yes, sir, I'll try my level best. So he explained, he himself, in front of the producer, cameraman, director, and the other people, he explained me everything about Kasaba and my character. And he said, are your dates available? Just imagine a big actor like this. He said, are your dates available? Come on, sir, please don't say like that. I said, sir, yes. I would love to do this film and I need your blessings. And I, like a fangirl, I went there. I said, sir, can I have one small picture with you? He's like, yeah, why not? Sure. It's like purely a blessing. You know, both of them, they are such top actors, but they're very sweet to their co-stars. They're very cooperative. They're very understanding. They'll help you. And I could see them that there is no stardom in their head. I think that's the reason today they are called as legendary actors, because they don't have that attitude. They help their co-artists. They support them. They encourage them. Lalitan was also, once we did the backup and everything, though we had so many pictures, we had scenes together. But still, you know, as a fangirl, I wanted to take a picture with him. So once the shoot, everything, it was like a wrap-up from Calicut. He said, you want to take a picture? Okay, yes, sir, I want to take a picture. He said, come on, we'll take a picture. He himself took my phone and he's taking the picture. And I'm like, look at both of them. You know, they both are such versatile actors. They both are so humble, so down to earth. I think these are the qualities which are making them to win everybody's heart. I have been on the set. I have seen them talking to even to the set boy, even to the light boy. They are very humble to each and everybody on the set. Yes, Mammootty doesn't speak that much, but when once he talks, he really talks a lot. And I also see Mammootty when we did the wrap up for Kasaba. He himself, he was serving biryani. He just put the mund like this and he started serving biryani to everybody. So that shows how humble they are, how down to earth, how simple they are. You cannot compare them that Mammootty is better than Lalitan or Lalitan is better with Mammootty. No. They are very, very beautiful people from the bottom of their heart in a very various reasons. You cannot compare them, seriously. I would never want to compare them. I'll tell you the first day of Kasaba. I had the scene with Varalakshmi and I had this lengthy dialogue they gave me. They said, Neha, you have to rehearse it. I think they were just pulling my leg. In fact, that was not the day I was supposed to do the shooting of that scene. That was next day. And I'm like, going on. I thought I'm sitting all alone. And I'm going. Behind me, there's a cameraman and director. They're silently standing and seeing me like this. And suddenly, I felt there is someone behind. I'm like, yes, sir. No. Study. Your board exam is there. So it was like that, because everybody is a Malayali there. People know Tamil, people know Malayalam, and I don't know anything, you know. And big words like, then they said, okay, which all words you have learnt? I said, Anakka Malayalam, kurchu varya, namaskaram, sugamano, and korpilla, and what? Anakka Malayalam padikum pattum. You know, I want to start learning Malayalam. So now I could see that improvement. When I went to Mohanlal sir's set, yes, I was understanding what people were talking. Then they say, Malayalam manslay. I said, manslay. I can understand everything. Then they said, now it is becoming a bit risky. In first film itself, she's learned Malayalam. Now you cannot talk something else in front of her. So be careful when you talk. I was like, okay. So funny moments is like, yes, the minute I don't know the pronunciation, I used to keep my mouth shut. If I'm saying the dialogue and if I feel, okay, now I don't know, I used to be. Why? Because where any singular word or any double meaning word comes out, Neha, teri to class lag jayegi. So I used to be quiet. So that's how I managed. So funny moments were there because people used to, yes, pull my leg all the time. Neha, speak in Malayalam. I'll be like, I don't know Malayalam. No, you have to talk in Malayalam. I was forced, when I say some word in a very different way, they used to say, no, your Malayalam is very cute. Oh, your Malayalam is very funny. So that's where now I decided, this time I'm giving the interview in English. Next time, I want to come here in the same office and I want to speak to you people and to my entire audience in Malayalam. This is what I promise to myself now. I'm basically from Dehradun. I'm born and brought up there. After that, in my family, I lost my dad before my birth. It's only me and my mother. So she's my world, you can say. She's my everything. Whatever I'm doing today, it's all because of her and for her I'm doing. I did my graduation in Dubai I'm a graduate in aviation, hotel management and business management. I worked with airlines. I worked in hotels as a manager. I always wanted to get into the industry, but my mother, you know, because I'm the only child and she's a single parent, and so she was a bit concerned. Industry venda. No. Continue your career in corporate life only. So just to keep her happy, I did everything in my corporate career, whatever I could, and very late I got inside the industry. But yes, in industry also, it was not that easy. How easy it looks from outside, the glamour, the shine, the glitter, it's not at all easy. And especially when you don't know anything in the industry, you don't have anybody to support you in the industry, it's not easy. So I had to come back from Dubai because my mother was not keeping well. I had to come back and be with her. Then I decided, okay, it's good, I should stay with her because she needs me. So then I tried looking for the job in Bangalore. I came to Bangalore, I started working with Mahindra Holidays. And I started my modeling ramps also in Bangalore. If you see, I entered into the industry very late, very, very, very late. Because my mother was not ready to get, you know, she was not at all ready. She was dead scared. And somehow I convinced her, but I understood the reality and cruelty of industry when I started giving auditions. I started going for auditions, for movie auditions. Wherever I go, yes, that point of time I was not even knowing Kannada. I used to say, Nange Kannada Gotilla, means I don't know Kannada. You go there, you get selected, you sign the contract. After 2 days, the call comes or the message comes, ma'am, can we meet outside for a cup of coffee? You'll be like, what? What does that mean? You know, I have heard the story, I have signed the agreement, and we are supposed to do the shooting. Why are they talking like this? So, you know the nonsense comes by. I was very, very irritated and frustrated giving auditions back to back and getting selected, and after that me rejecting it because of some nonsense reasons, because they have like, you know, all those casting couch and all what we face. I was not ready for the shortcut. It was very difficult, very, very difficult. Wherever you go, you get selected, but after a day or two, you get rejected. Why? Because you're not ready for their terms and conditions. I had the face, I had the talent, but I was not having the will to do something wrong to get success. So that's the reason I was getting rejected. It's an art. Art is something which is like a God's gift. You cannot buy it. You need to have that gift from God. I'm sorry, I'm being little very harsh on my words, but I will say, the day girls will start saying no to casting couch, nobody will force you, because nobody forces here. In industry, nobody forces you that you have to, you know, compromise and all that. Nobody forces you. It's your own will. These days, girls, they want to take a shortcut. They want to be a part of the industry. They want to see glamour. They want to see stardom. They are ready to do anything and everything, which is a very, very wrong thing. Because of such people, the girls who are actually talented, the girls who have got really caliber to act on screen and who are really good looking. Even if it's not about the good looking, it's about your art. There are so many actresses and actors who are not that great by appearance, but they're very fantastic actors. So it's somewhere we are responsible to give that label to the industry that industry is bad. I'm sorry, industry is not bad. It's about the people who are getting in the industry, because they are here only for fun. They are not here for passion. They are not here for taking this industry seriously till their lifelong. they just want to come inside, they want to enjoy the stardom, and they just want to exit. That's it. Wherever I go for audition, getting selected, and after 2 days, you know, there are messages coming and all that. Hi, can I meet you outside? Hi, can you dress up in short dresses? Can we go out for a dinner and all that? I got so frustrated, I stopped going for auditions. Especially a special message I want to give it to the female artists out there. In our country, in India, especially the amount of respect what we give to a woman, we are known for that. Respect yourself. Don't lose your dignity, don't lose yourself just because you want to become a star. I stopped giving auditions for the films. I stopped giving it. One day I had a ramp show in Bangalore. After finishing the show, I was going towards my car. And then one of the director called Mr. Hasuraj Shekhar, who is an award-winning director. He was about to direct his 100th film. So he was looking out for a female lead. So this man calls me from back and he's like, excuse me. I just turn around. I'm like, yes. Like, hi, I'm Asura Shekhar, an award-winning director, and I would like to cast you for my film. Just imagine what will be my expression. I'll be like, oh yeah. So sir, what do you want me to do for you if you want to cast me in the film? He's like, what? No, I know that you will also come up with a lot of your own conditions, this and that. It's like, no, I'm not interested in all those things. You're like my daughter. Then I said, are you sure, sir? He said, yes. Then that's how, you know, my impression towards the industry changed a little bit. Because I'm here for my passion, not for the desperation. I would prefer to be an actress for my husband with whomsoever I'll get married in future, rather becoming an actress after doing wrong things or shortcuts. I don't believe in shortcuts. So he gave me a break for my first film called Rickshaw Driver, and that was a Tulu cinema. Again, a very tongue-twisting language. I was not getting Kannada only, I got Tulu language immediately. And we started shooting for it, and movie won 11 awards. It won state award. I won the award for the best actress 2012, 13, even for 14. Taking awards in the other languages, it's really a very big thing. It's really a blessing. And now I'm looking forward for the same in Malayalam also. So for that, I'm looking forward to some really, really very good roles which can, bring in the real artist out of me, the real actor. Cinema over here is very, very realistic. And the heroines look really very pretty decent, you know, in saris, dressed up in saris, very normal, minute makeup. And technically, people are very strong over here. And if you see, a lot of Malayalam films are getting remade in Bollywood. So why Bollywood people are picking up films from Malayalam? Because they know that the films which we make here are really have got good subject, you know, that strength is there in that story. So there are, and you see, a lot of directors, a lot of artists, they're national award winners, and they're especially from Malayalam industry. So it's about that power of Mollywood, which is there. You can say Malayalam industry is actually becoming my learning school right now. You know, I have become a student of Malayalam industry right now as an artist. People here make very realistic cinema. Malayalam cinema is very realistic, where the heroines are not exploited on the screen. They look extremely simple in their appearance, in their acting. And I see there are a lot of artists who are national award winners from here. And a lot of artists, a lot of directors, means a lot of technicians. So it means this industry has got a lot to offer. Lots of love, lots of prayers, and lots of good wishes ahead for each one of you. Stay happy, stay blessed. Never and ever let yourself down. And, you know, the more you'll spread love, the more you'll spread smiles, the more you'll spread positivity around you, God will keep blessing you in one or the other way. So never and ever become weak in your life. Stay strong, stay happy. Love you all.